According to legend, Tequila was born in fire. On top of the volcán de Tequila, a spiky blue agave plant is said to have exploded when it was struck by lightning. When the indigenous people tasted the sweet nectar from inside the plant, they asked for the blessing of the goddess of agave, Mayahuel, and so was born Tequila, the spirit that would intoxicate the world. Today, the rich red soil of the Jalisco Highlands produces some of Mexico's finest tequilas, among them the legendary Siete Leguas. In the chill of pre-dawn, workers walk through a field of agave to determine its readiness to be harvested. They check the conditions of the leaves, looking for traces of insects or other problems, and if all the signs are good, they will call in the crews of jimidores, the agave harvesters. It is not easy to harvest the agave, especially in these hilly fields. First, the agave must be cut away from the root. And then the leaves, called pencas, must be removed. This is a dangerous operation that takes much skill and experience, using a sharp hoe-like tool called the coa of the jima, or simply coa. On a busy day, the fields echo with the distinctive sound of the blades chopping away the leaves to reach the piña, the heart of the agave, each of which can weigh well over 50 pounds. The easiest way to get the heavy piñas down the hilly terrain to the flat truck loading area is to use highly trained mules, which are bred in the U.S. state of Kentucky for this very purpose. When these mules sense the weight of a full basket of piñas, they walk themselves down to the loading area without the need to be prompted or led. In an industry that is increasingly being dominated by multinational conglomerates and movie stars, Siete Leguas does things the traditional way. Don Ignacio González Vargas established the company and its fábrica El Centenario Distillery in 1952 in the town of Atotonilco El Alto. Here, the agave are roasted in brick ovens called molinos, and sugars are squeezed out of the fibers using a large millstone called a tajona wheel, which is hewn out of local volcanic rock. This tajona wheel is the last one in Mexico to be pulled the traditional way, by two mules. In a building that is part museum, part distillery, the agave extract is fermented in large tanks, using only natural yeasts and water from a spring called Taretan, located high in the hills above town. It's a painstaking process, and one that seems, at times, to be supervised by the founder himself, seen here in one of the many historic photographs that line the distillery walls. Between batches, the tanks are thoroughly washed out while the agave juice is being distilled three times in copper vats before being consigned to oak barrels, many of which are sourced from American bourbon makers, explains Beto Hernandez, one of the founder's grandsons. Siete leguas literally means 7 leagues, which is a distance of about 21 miles. It was the name given to the horse of legendary Mexican revolutionary Pancho Villa, when the brave mare carried her rider over 20 miles to safety after a battle in which both horse and rider were wounded. From that day on, Villa called his horse Siete Leguas. The elder González promised his friends in Villa's family that, should he ever achieve his dream of opening a distillery, he would name it after the revolutionary hero's favorite horse. Today, Siete Leguas is the last of the major tequila companies that remains family-owned and operated. For many decades, it was a boutique brand, enjoyed in area taverns the local way, with the juice of a sweet lime or a pink grapefruit, as well as by aficionados throughout Mexico and the United States. But with the surge of interest throughout the world in quality tequilas, Siete Leguas is now being exported to the UK, Europe, and other parts of the globe. It's all part of the growth of the legendary liquid they call Mexico's gift to the world.
Siete leguas el caballo que Villa más estimaba. Cuando ya silbar los trenes, se paraba y relinchaba.
Como a las tres de la
Villa,
silbarán los locomotores.
Adiós, torres.